Hello, I'm Steve Davis, president of the Barrett-Jackson Auction Company. In this video, we'd like to introduce you to an exciting new product from Planet Color. This new color line from Planet Color is called the Barrett-Jackson Collector Color Series. Together with the folks from Planet Color, we've come up with an exciting color palette of 25 colors. Colors as seen on some of the top-selling vehicles ever to cross the auction block at Barrett-Jackson. For this demonstration video, we'll be painting my personal vehicle, a 64 Ford Fairlane Baby Bolt. I've chosen a color from the palette called Red Hot Chili Pepper. In this video, we'll show you all 7 steps to create a killer paint job for your vehicle. These steps will help define everything you'll need to assure a great job and a fantastic finish. To help with your project, make sure you have this applications guide as found on the Planet Color website. You can download a copy of it as it has all the information we'll discuss in this video. So let's get started.
As with any paint job, proper preparation is key to obtaining great results. Before any bodywork is begun, make sure the vehicle has been completely cleaned. First, we wash the car with hot, soapy water. After the car has been completely dried, we'll clean with a solvent surface cleaner. Using Finish One surface cleaner, we wipe on with a wet cloth and immediately wipe off with a dry, clean cloth. Before applying body filler, sand the area with 80 grit sandpaper to ensure proper adhesion. Shape body filler to the contours of the body with 80 grit paper. Finish, sand, and feather edge surrounding areas with 180 grit sandpaper, then sand areas with 320 grit. To avoid seeing sand scratches later in your work, final sand with 400 grit sandpaper before applying primer surfacer as defined in step 3. If any bare steel has been exposed during the bodywork process, make sure to apply etching primer, part number FP301, to the surface. The etching primer provides a tough adhesion to the bare metal and durable corrosion resistance. Spray one medium coat of etch primer over base metal areas only. Allow etch primer to dry a minimum of 30 minutes before recoating. Sanding is not required if etch primer is recoated within 24 hours. After all bare metal has been coated with etching primer and allowed 30 minutes to dry, we now move on to our Finish One primer surfacer, part number FP410. With an HVLP spray gun, we set a gun pressure of 20 to 25 PSI, or 5 to 7 PSI at the cap, and a fluid tip of 1.4 millimeters. We applied 2 to 3 medium wet coats, allowing about 3 minutes flash time between coats. When spraying the primer surfacer, avoid applying one heavy coat, as it is better to apply several medium coats. Wait 30 minutes to dry before recoating with primer surfacer. Our primer surfacer must be recoated within 24 hours or be resanded and scuffed. FP410 filler primer can be sanded in approximately 2 hours at 70 degrees Fahrenheit. Block sanding with 400 to 600 grit sandpaper. For larger areas needing body repair, use 120 grit paper, finishing with 220 on a long blocking board. This will help in making the bodywork as straight as possible. Remember, all good paint jobs are the result of patient and quality vehicle preparation. With the bodywork completed and all imperfections sanded away, now we're ready to apply the primer sealer. Depending on your choice of base coat color, make sure to choose the correct sealer color as it relates to your base coat color. Do not miss this step. To find this information, refer to the applications guide under step 4, Primer Sealer, Color Selection Guide. In this example, we're painting Steve's car with Red Hot Chili Pepper, base coat color number PCFP2. According to the color selection guide, we need a white sealer, so we'll use sealer part number FS514. Adjusting our gun pressure to 30 to 35 PSI, and with a 1.2 fluid tip, we apply one full wet coat at a distance of 4 to 7 inches. You want to allow primer sealer to dry 10 minutes before applying base coat color. Note, base coat must be applied within 8 hours of sealer coat. Now that we have completed all the steps of priming and we applied our colored sealer that color coordinates with the base coat color, we can move forward and apply the base coat. Note, the Planet Color Barrett-Jackson colors are pint filled in a quart can for ease of mixing on smaller jobs. Since the mix ratio is 1:1, simply top off the can. On larger jobs requiring multiple cans of color, thoroughly mix each can separately, then pour each can into one larger container. This helps keep color and metallic consistency. Spray application in Canada and California require mixing the base coat color with a 3.5 VOC compliant reducer hardener, part number PCRD1 or PCRD2, depending on air temperature. We're spraying this vehicle in Arizona, so the reducer hardener we're using is the 5.0 National Rule Reducer. Choose from one of the temperature ratings of PCS 15 through PCS 45. Again, the mix ratio is 1:1. For increased hiding, colors can be reduced 2:1. Before spraying, blow off the vehicle's surface with pressurized air, then lightly clean with a tack rag. With a gun pressure of 30 to 35 PSI and a 1.3 fluid tip, apply base coat as normal with a horizontal coat, overlapping each pass at a 70% overlap. Apply 3 to 4 coats or until color has been achieved. Allow a minimum of 20 minutes at 70 degrees Fahrenheit before clear coating. For the clear coat step, we'll be using our Overall Clear, part number FC720. Mix the clear coat with one of the FH611, 612, or FH613 hardeners, depending on your temperature. Since today is 80 degrees Fahrenheit, we'll use the FH612 hardener. All Finish 1 clear coats mix at a ratio of 4 parts clear coat to 1 part hardener. To find the correct hardener that relates to the temperature in which you'll be spraying, refer to the Applications Guide in Step 6 under the Hardener Selection Chart to locate the part number of the required hardener. With a gun pressure of 30 to 35 PSI and a fluid tip of 1.3, apply 2 coats of clear, allowing 2 to 5 minutes to flash between coats. Clear coat can be baked at 120 degrees Fahrenheit surface temperature for 30 minutes. Before applying the clear coat, make sure the base coat is tacked up, becoming finger slick. To determine if the surface is ready for clear coat and without damaging your vehicle finish, lightly rub your finger over a piece of tape or in a masked area. If the base coat color does not rub off onto your finger, you should be ready for clearing. For ultra flat, deep wet clear coat appearance, apply 2 to 3 coats of clear. Run through bake cycle or allow 24 hours for surface to cure or cool. Sand flat with 800 grit paper to remove excess orange peel. Wipe surface clean and reapply 2 additional coats of clear. For a superior finish, creating a dazzling high gloss appearance, cross cut sand the clear coat using 2000 or finer sandpaper. Be very careful around the edges and corners as you don't want to sand through the clear coat. When all orange peel and undesired texture has been removed, wipe clean with a microfiber towel. With a high-speed polisher, buff surface to a high-gloss finish using a quality micro-finishing compound. To remove any finer scratches, follow up the process with a micro-finishing glaze. Now that the work is finished, let's admire your killer paint job.